Hey everybody, welcome back to Northern Land Plays the Binding of Isaac Rebirth. I was really actually quite happy with that last run. We've done our part, you know, we won as Isaac, Maggie, Cain, and Judas. Now it's time to keep the streak alive through the slightly more difficult section of the game. Although, I'll admit, I do love Blue Baby, and of course Azazel as well. FJ4L is the second half, WYV4 is the first half. I don't know why I said that, it was like I was trying to do a captcha or something, or fool some kind of AI. It's alright though. We're on a little bit of a roll today. I think I've only got one loss today. That first one as Eden, which was a bullshit run to begin with, but anyway. We'll get back to Eden eventually, and we'll give her the what for. Or we won't. Because we could just as easily start with, like, you know, Lemon Mishap, Black Bean, or something like that. I'm glad that Eden is like that, though, you know? I have, you know, occasionally someone will be like, oh, man, there should be, like, two different pools, and Eden should pull, like, one good item, one bad item. Where's the fun in that, right? I wanna have some Eden runs that are nearly impossible to win with and see if you can win with them. Well, nearly impossible to win with from the start, at least. And then some Eden runs where it's like, oh, we're gonna start with, like, you know, Godhead, Sacred Heart. Okay, that's fine, too. I want to take this pill, but I don't want to take this pill because I'm very concerned that it could be bad trip. You know, this is an important floor for the momentum of our run overall. If we end up fighting ourselves a haunt on this floor, I really don't want to go in there with 1 HP and no bombs. I don't want to go in there with 2 HP and no bombs either. I don't want to go in there with 2 HP and one bomb. It's a very... I don't want to go in there is basically what I'm trying to get. Look at this. Motherfucker, can you cool it here? Less speed, more speed to cruise control, please. What are you doing, spider? I like the hoopa and the hoopa and the... Okay, just seriously. Fuck off. Stop moving. You're not entitled to movement anymore, alright? If I never see you again, it's gonna be too soon. It's good. Give me a bomb. This is, you know, give me 10 bombs in this item room. Go buy your mama a bomb. Come back and ask for more. Okay? This is one of the rare situations where, you know, people say, give a man a fish, he'll eat for a day, teach a man a fish, he'll eat for a lifetime, where I think that's horseshit. How about teach a man to fish and give him a fish so that he can still be full while he's learning to eat for a lifetime? You can't just teach, hey, thanks for teaching me how to fish. Too bad it took me a couple of days to master it, so I fucking starved to death. That's how I feel about it right now. I got a bomb bag, which is great if I actually get a bomb. Okay, well, this is good. We're going to get a spirit heart, and we've got our cube of meat dreams. I dream about a meat got a shape like Destiny's Child. Just a little glimpse of Madonna's wild side with Janet Jackson's smile. Roll in her body like Jennifer. She's the star of my liquid dreams. We're also going to get a spirit heart. Spirit hurt? Well, my spirits have been hurt thus far by what's been going on. But still, we got a chance to get a spirit heart if we win this. Or we could just die. Those are the outcomes that are currently available to us. Also, if we could just get... Oh, I almost walked right into him. If we could just get Bomb Bag to actually pay out ASAP, could be amazing. There's like a Tinted Rock plus Bomb combo coming up on the other room. Let me go back. Thank God. We didn't get a freaking bomb, though. Where's my bomb? I want a bomb. We could just boom right here, and then we'll get another... We could get two Tinted Rocks with one bomb. You're not going to give me any bombs? Ugh. On the bright side, the cube of meat percentage chance pipe dream is still alive. On the downside, we're on the cellar, and we haven't fought Haunt yet. I don't think we're going to have a clash situation. You know, I fought the Haunt and the Haunt won, but I would prefer to avoid it altogether if possible. I like those stone chests. Oh, come on. I like them a lot. Now we get two bombs that drop immediately. If you don't give me some fucking Tinted Rocks, I am gonna cause a riot. Get ready. It's gonna happen. Remember my promise. Thank you for despawning all of your good stuff there. Okay, we gotta. We don't have to do it anymore. We can slow down a little bit. Let's just cool a little bit. Cool it a little bit. Now remember, I'm still looking for Book of Revelations. Oh my god, I'm the worst Isaac player in the world. If we, get... say a Book of Revelations. I don't want to pick up that battery because I may actually need it to survive, which is embarrassing. That money is real, though. That's cold hard cash there. We could use that. We're going to use that. Oh my god, there's a tinted rock too. You're too good to me, game. You're too- Oh my god, you- Death is my bitch mother! I need- Oh my god, come on. Come on. Work with me. We're working together here, game. Not working apart. How many different possible, like- This is like the definition of, like, you know, bad luck is more than the sum of its parts. Come on. I've been taking some dumb damage in the process. I'll own up to it. I can change, baby. But hook me up. Give me a single freaking thank you. A single freaking thank you. A single freaking spirit heart. I appreciate that. You smart, you loyal, all that jazz. All right, there's our boss fight. But mostly I'm interested in the shop here. We're lucky to be alive. But, you know, we're also unlucky because we could have, like, six spirit hearts right now if drops had happened in a slightly different order. Of course, our shop does not even contain a single spirit heart, because that'd be too easy. And it's Fistula. We've been fighting Fistula all freaking day. Is it Fistula Friday? Get out of here. Most important thing is keep the detritus where it belongs, far, far away from my face. Now, we're going to get through this fight just fine. We're not going to have any spirit arts to take a deal with the devil, so we might end up with a deal with the angel. But if we get 9 lives, the mark, the pact, we can take a deal and live. We get Guppy's collar, we can maybe take a deal and live. Ceremonial robes. There's a lot of potential options here. Give me a spirit art. Give me a spirit art. Ugh, well, okay, maybe it's for the best. I can't do it. I'll get myself killed. I can't do it. I was tempted to do it. We got a health upgrade there, but at the same time, I just can't do it. This run is just it's a nightmare. Considering we got a health up pill, I'm relatively comfortable buying the coin purse from the shop. Checking for like a quarter or just some spare change here, I guess. If we get a quarter from the shop, that could be pretty good. Not a quarter from the shop, sorry, the coin purse from the shop. That could be pretty good. We could also get some health downgrades, speed downgrades, tiers downgrades, etc., etc., but the chance of there being HP upgrades, I think, is what makes that doable, especially since we're going to really be wanting to get deals with the devil in the future, if the game is lucky and like generous enough to actually give us some, and that's something that's very much up in the air. I wonder if they could block them and send them back in the other direction. You know, it's just a penny. Just let it go, man. Yeah, I mean, we'll open this. Give me, like, Tammy's head or something. Well, that's a lot of money and all of our consumables back, so I'll take it. I had to do my due diligence here. You know, I love Boss Rush as much as the next person, but you know what I love more than that? Never having to worry about having to get cubes of meat early on in the game ever again. Unfortunately, we haven't really made that dream a reality. We already checked over here. Where? Oh, our secret room is probably all the way over there then. Am I really going to go back for one penny? Answer, yes. You know what? We can take a sneak peek and see what's in here. And then decide if we really want it. This might be a total waste of 2 bombs, but we can still get in on one of these sides if we want to. Oh! Okay, 1 bomb then. To get all that, I think that's worth it. It's a very roundabout way of doing things here. But I think it's alright. We got 39 cents. 39 cents! That's kind of crazy. You might be saying, hey, buy magic fingers. Our damage kind of sucks though. I don't think we need magic fingers. I'm just happy to be freaking alive right now. This shouldn't be our secret room. Yeah. Well, we traded a bomb for a key. Well, I've totally, like, fucked up our secret room placement then. Second? Yeah, second secret room. Pills! 2 pheromones. 2 of those. 1 of these. Okay. Luck down. We don't want that. Do I still want to buy this coin purse? I think I do, just because I got the money for it. Yeah, let's do it. Tears down. 2 lemon parties. And bad gas. Well, that's the most I've ever paid for a tiers downgrade, that's for sure. I'd say we move on to the next floor. How do I feel? I don't know. I mean, it could be worse. We came pretty close to death a couple of times there, so to still be alive is pretty nice. I'm a fan of that. Teleport me to your leader, please. Take me to the candy shop. Let me lick the lollipop. In all seriousness, though, please. Don't take me to the candy shop, but teleport me to the deal with the devil next time, Red Chest, if you have a chance, please. I like that. I don't like this so much. We're gonna... Oh my god, I should have been hit already there. I appreciate the orbitals. I don't really care about this pheromones card. Or pill. What a shoddy coin purse. But hey, petrified poop. That's what you want. And I was like, wow, now we should have taken magic fingers. But no, it doesn't make any sense. Because then we wouldn't have the poop to shoot every room. We'd have magic fingers, though, which would make rooms like this a little bit easier, but we'd spend way too much money too early. Anyway. This money's gonna add up. It's a good thing. I really like what Boney did with the place there. They just, like, bone-fucked each other to death. I appreciate that. Wow, petrified poop really paying out like crazy so far. Don't break the bank too much, I'd feel guilty. It's nice having attack fly, you know, it's not quite as damaging, of course, as Sacrificial Dagger, but it's substantially safer. Also rotates at about, you know, 1 pixel per second, but keep moving on, I suppose. I hate being on the third floor with no damage. We actually have lower damage than we started with. That's the kiss of death, man. Because you are going to take a lot of damage out of impatience. Or I'm going to take a lot of damage out of impatience. That's on me, though. But the earlier you get out of that tailspin, the better it is for you. I mean, I guess it's kind of implied whenever there's a tailspin, the earlier you get out, the better it is. But the problem is that we don't have any damage, so it takes us a long time to gain any sort of momentum, kill any enemies, as you can see right here. However, that's good. One deal with the devil... One good deal with the angel, or a few different kinds of shop items can sort us right out. Awful, awful damage. Just keeps getting worse. Get out of there. I was frozen. I couldn't move. I was in another world. Oh, come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Oh, yes. Okay, it worked. All right, this is a big moment. Fuck everything. This has been, like, the most nerve-wracking run I've ever had. That's not true. But certainly, it's up there. I know we got petrified poop. I know. We have to take this. It's completely conceivable that, that the poop is gonna be worse than the coin purse or than the mom's bottle of pills. We gotta try, though. Petrified poop, hey, it's pulling its weight now. We are in a position where we could make good on a deal with the devil. However, we need to get one. And on this floor, we're unlikely to get any special deals. If we get a special deal, it's more likely than not gonna be a deal with the angel, because we already shit on our deal with the devil precedent. They gave us Sacrificial Dagger. They're like, come on, you love Sag. Just try it, pussy. Sacrificial Dagger. You remember how much you used to like the feeling that Sacrificial Dagger gave you back before you went clean. That's what I'm dealing with right now. I'm not a chicken, you're a turkey. Appear to be energy resources. I've never seen anything like this on Oith. So much better if I can just get Attack Fly actually in there. Even for just a little bit of damage, it's nice. Oh, thank you. Cube of meat. I forgot that I should have been looking for... Book of Revelations on this floor. Hopefully we find one next floor. Again, that's kind of what you expect. No deal with the devil there. It's okay. We'll get through this. It gets better. We desperately need to visit our item room. One good item room could tear this run a brand new butthole. And that's like a good thing, I guess. It's a sign of extreme change. Yeah, tear it a new asshole, I guess, is not always a positive thing. In fact, you know, in real life, I would assume that it's a negative thing, unless you, like, your old one got plugged up and, you know, doctors had to give you, like, an ostomy or something like that. For now, look, this, we should have gone with Sacrificial Dagger, because I'm using inferior orbitals to accomplish the same thing. These spirit hearts from, I guess petrified poop, but from the poop in general, are making me so happy. We will explode you, post-haste. Sure. I'm gonna definitely go to our curse room. Please give me the goat head. Oh, man, that would have been bad. Spirit hearts and the goat head. Okay, we broke even at least. Alright, we completely broke even. So I guess we're leaving this floor. And again, we got items that pretty much just keep us on life support here as we await what happens next. What do you think? You think? What do you think? You think? I think. Yeah. Okay. Well, we tried. Can't get away from those bombs, unfortunately. And it's down to the next floor with, you know, yet another sack to add to our collection. Symbolizes dope, take a toke, but don't choke. If you do, you got no clue of what me and my homie Snoop Dogg came to do. It's just like that. Now, I'm honestly, like, kind of happy we took damage there. I'm not sad about it, that one. Curse of the Unknown is some fucked up shit right now. I apologize for my language, but this has been a very poor Blue Baby run. We can't really live like this forever. We have to get some kind of... Well, we don't have to, but it's likely that we'll get some kind of deal on this floor. It's pretty unlikely that we can use one bomb to knock those over. Those are not red chests. I think I still gotta kind of go with it, though. Oh! Oh, I'm so glad I opened them. Okay. It's a start. Normally, Cricket's Head is an end, but it's a start. By getting Cricket's Head, we can at least kill enemies without having to resort to using Attack Fly. Not that that's a bad thing. It's actually doing quite a number here. But thank fucking Christ. Now, Cricket's Head shows up on so many one runs that you might think that it means that this run is won. It's not. But it's a damn good start. Thank goddamn Christ. Mega Maw always spawns in, like, the weirdest locations in here. Sorry, we don't need to stand close anymore. Just stay away, and then Attack Fly does its dirty work, and you're done. We've taken some damage. We've taken more damage than we should have on this floor in general. I would really be sad if we died after finally achieving some semblance of acceptable damage. You're gonna explode. We gotta get out of there. Okay, certainly enough money to buy anything we want from our shop. As long as we're not fighting greed, that's why we'll do item room first. Yeah, I like chocolate milk well enough. It's not, oh, I love that. It's not so good that we can declare it a one run, but it's extremely helpful. So I'm gonna bypass the map for now, but we'll come back for it if we can. Because we got the stopwatch, which a lot of people would consider a one run in and of itself right there. Plus, we picked up another spirit heart. So this is actually very, very, very nice. And the main value of chocolate milk, I've talked about this a lot, but is in basically one-shotting an enemy every time you enter a room. Yeah, there it is right there. Especially with Cricket's Head. So the tap shooting is, like, more effective DPS, I think. At least it certainly feels like it. But the big tier is really going to hook you up with one enemy per room. Yeah, we got to try this. Could be, like, Guppy's Head, Tammy's Head. There's a lot of head items in these chests. Got more bombs out of it. We didn't quite kill the Keeper in one hit, but we're going to get close. These guys can't even hit us anymore. Yeah, Broken Stopwatch, look. I'll own up to the fact I think Broken Stopwatch almost makes the game not fun just because it's so good. But I like that. I can live with that. Please tell me. You know, we can still get our cube of meat aspirations coming true here. So we're not going to fight the boss just yet. That should be relatively obvious, though. We're going to be hoping that we don't have to fight the boss just yet either, yeah. In that double key room, I don't think double key rooms can be libraries, but, you know, I have myself second-guessing everything. Can't fight him yet. Sure, why not, right? We could still get super lucky and end up, yeah, we could still get super lucky and end up just fighting Pestilence. It's happened. It's happened a lot, actually. Well, it's happened a few times. But that's what I'm looking for right there, was more, just getting a single key drop. So we at least have the chance to check out the double key room. I'm not rerolling this run, though. You can't ask me in good conscience to reroll this run after I've just worked my ass off to get to the point where it's valuable. I put my blood, sweat, and my fucking tears into this run. We're sticking with it. In the meantime, though, you know, forget boss rush. We're going so slowly. We have to, though. Secret room? Secret room? Come on. Secret room contains just more bombs. Is this some kind of cruel joke? We're going back for the map now. I'm also thinking, you know, try these on for size. We got a health up and a luck down. Hey, two spirit hearts, or sorry, two bombs for a spirit heart, I think is pretty good. We'll be able to get a map. You know what? Let's get another key. I think we've earned it. This run has required some decent play. So I'm really hoping that this is our, you know, our coming out party. I'm hoping that this is where we get fed, to put it in like Dota terms or like MOBA terms. I'm hoping this is where we get our crazy good deal with the devil or angel item. We'll see though. All right, so that's like a full spirit heart technically. Temperance, which we'll throw down and we'll get something out of it. Might as well try this on for size. But we're going to have to hope that we're fighting Pestilence here, which is unlikely. I just traded a bomb for a penny. That's how crazy I am right now. I think with Petrified Poop, we got to stick with the poop, honestly. Bob's Rotten Head is a little bit overrated, even though everyone hates it. Sorry, Bob's Rotten Head. Okay. That's our third Eternal Heart on this floor without having Prayer Card. That doesn't happen all that often. So Dingle, not much of a problem when you're rolling with broken or regular stopwatch and a handful of orbitals here. You are in for a bad time, my friend. I mean, we're still not doing knockout damage, but we did very well there. What else you got for me? Okay, we did get a deal with the angel. Our deal with the angel is the soul. The soul is good enough to take and stick with deal with the angel precedent, I think. First off, it's free. Secondly, it deflects bullets, which is very good if I'm going to be using my orbitals, but sometimes you can still get hit with the soul. That's all right, though. I'm happy with this. I'm starting to think that maybe the game's going to be kind to us. But, like, Jesus fuck, we earned it. Can't fly. Why did I think that I could fly? Thank you, soul. I think we've earned it. If you compare this to other recent runs where we got, like, super high damage and then blew it, this is the run where we've actually earned it. This is the proof that life isn't fair. Because we've done our best and not been rewarded. On a lot of runs, work my butt off, or don't work my butt off, and end up succeeding anyway. Now, these guys don't give a shit. Even with broken stopwatch, they're still, like, fast enough to catch me off guard. Broken stopwatch so good though for making omelets. You didn't expect that I was gonna say that, but it's true, man. But the broken stopwatch is so good for making our orbitals better as well. That's where I was actually gonna go with that. You're not dead, huh? I guess we could probably get rid of petrified poop on this floor. I've been a little attached to it though, for I think good reason, you know. It's helped us buy some shop items we wouldn't have otherwise been able to afford. I hate slow mom's Wallmaster things here. Take 100 years to step down. There we go. And then we got these gentlemen right here. Slow enemies that jump. Always throw off my internal timing. Straight up, thought I could fly there. I think it's just because our speed's so high right now. Probably better off with black lipstick. Let's take it. We've got enough money to get items from the next two shops. One item from the next two shops. You're not supposed to be able to turn on a dime like that, mister. Why am I tempting fate like this? Because that's the kind of player I am. Plus, we have a lot of HP for once. That feels pretty good. Akina Bomb. Thank you, Mystery Sack. Gotta use this every room. Might be missing out on a Spirit Heart. Might be missing out on nothing, but we might be missing out on a Spirit Heart. Poison Touch. We're guaranteed to have permanent Polaroid invincibility, so it's fine. Thank you, I'm assuming Black Lipstick, for that action right there. We got some kind of special room down here. I guess we're giving up the ghost on Cuba Me. We don't have any hope there. Forgot to think about that as I was fighting our bosses. I like this, though. Very decent chance of getting a Black Market, which we could totally afford if it takes Spirit Hearts. Yeah. Please. Good. Let's shoot this first, just in case we get... Well, what do we even want at this point? But hey. Alright. It's just a free item, but the free item is Holy Water. Honestly, this might sound shitty, but it's actually kind of okay. Because normally, this is like the thing you're most worried about, is going into this boss... going into the Angel Room and being like, ugh, Holy Water. So, lucky for us, we won't have to deal with that, because we just got Holy Water for free. I mean, the crux of the problem is just that holy water sucks, but at least we're not wasting a sweet room this time. So now we can, if we're going to get rid of petrified poop, that means we can get rid of our poop as well. You know, whatever we find to replace it would be excellent. Like, literally almost anything would be better. As much as I've loved the Spirit Hearts. I mean, Flat Penny is not even that good for us in our current situation. We might be better off with the Lipstick, but I love keys, man. And I spend them. Seems to make sense to get more. The slowest Blue Baby run in human history. Is it wrong that I actually want Shoop the Whoop right now? Like, these are a juicy target right here. That's alright. I guess we can just sneak in there. And with our orbitals, do a little mirepoix crunch. Doesn't really make any sense, but just consider that that's like a wrestling move or something. This is going to be like a 90-minute Blue Baby run. Unless I get Godhead on our next deal with the Angel. That's great damage. Very happy with that. Alright, well, Pandora's Box. We take it. I think we should take this as well. Why Pandora's Box? It's versatile. My intention right now is to use it to get yet another angel item. Oh, I don't want counterfeit penny. Use it to get yet another angel item on the cathedral. However, if we find a better spacebar item, we could use it on Utero 1 or 2, that is, in order to do all right there. Oh, this is tedious. Or, come on. We could use it on... the cathedral to get the angel item as intended. We could even use it on this floor to get 20 cents for the 15 that we paid for it if we really needed 5 extra cents, which, I mean, we could use 5 extra cents, but I don't really want to buy Sharp Plug. Seriously, though. Thank you. The devil. I'd like some black hearts. I can't believe we're only on Necropolis 1. Okay, 2 devil cards, that's fine. Double Wretched. Didn't we pass up? No, we didn't pass up Missing Page 2. That's my mistake. So I might as well pop 1 devil card here. Please give me a deal with the angel. I desire some more damage. We're in such a good position on this run anyway. Just entirely as a result of this broken stopwatch, basically. And also, you know, Chocolate Milk Cricket's head is at least something. But give me the deal with the angel. Give me the chances to, you know, pick up as many of those good items as we can. Give me a Sacred Heart Godhead chance. Ability to fly, something like that. I already think I have the ability to fly. Nothing. A Spirit Heart. Ugh. Ugh. What are you doing down there, Tomo? Trying to hide from me. Sneaking around. You can't see me because I've evolved invincibility. So it wasn't this floor that we could actually get the 20 cents. It's next floor where we can get the 20 cents. I got a little ahead of myself, mostly because I thought this run was actually making progress, but I was mistaken. I wonder if we can bomb our way into our curse room. That would be one of the small positive lights here. That would be very... Not that this run is bad. It's just very, very slow. Oh, that rune could turn my frown upside down. Ah, it's the rune! Tarun! Nah, this is good. So that doubles our chest. Oh, please be good. Black Candle, it's okay. At least we don't have Curse of the Blind on this floor anymore, or does it just work in the future? Because I would like for it to work right now. And make it so we can actually see our items. Black Candle's okay. You know, I love talking about the item pools when I understand them. And it's good that we've got Black Candle, because it means that Black Candle won't be in our shop pool. Not that it's a bad item, but again, anytime you get a good item, the other good thing about it is that you can get another good item in your next shop, because you already got that good item. Parasite. Parasite is pretty solid. Really nice synergies to go along with it. Can help us do a lot of damage to multiple enemies simultaneously. This plus Cricket's body is like my dream layout here, if I could just get some extra damage on top of it as well. I hope this isn't the way to the boss, because if it is, we'll have to backtrack. Okay, you're in for a rough time. We might know those pills. Why even come to this area? What is wrong with me? It's alright. Two of these shots at full charge, enough. Wow. The charge shot is actually... Oh, it's a champion, that's why. I was like, we should be doing more damage against this guy. Luck down. Continues to just be a bounty, a delight to the senses. The least frustrating run we've ever had. Creep, right? That's my bad. I do that a lot. Not the game's fault. We are 8 minutes shy of being able to get into boss rush. Boss rush, which is like the, probably the slowest run that I've had in at least a week. I know there's multiple areas we could look for secret rooms, but I kind of just want to throw out occasional ones now and then. Save our bombs for other stuff. We should bomb below us here, although. Actually, we should bomb above us. Although, I think we already looked there. Lucky Justice card, honestly. Normally, you don't get a Spirit Heart out of it. When you do, it always feels nice, especially when you're Blue Baby. And the Red Heart wouldn't have helped at all. Alright, there's our shop. As anticipated. Attack Fly plus Broken Stopwatch really good here, but... I wish we could just maybe kill the enemies a little bit faster. Because, like, I feel like they can't really offer much in their own defense. But at the same time, it's taken me forever to kill them and put them out of their own misery, you know? I'm just thinking about them. Unfortunately, that's our last shop, so the whole conversation about Black Candle is entirely meaningless. Let us go fight Mom. And we're getting ever closer to getting that free deal with the angel item. And even closer, I guess, eventually. I don't know where our second secret room would be here. Even closer eventually to being able to actually use this Yara rune effectively, which I'm pretty excited about. Not totally sure what hit me there. Can't see shit, Captain. I need, like... Okay, first off, I need the enemies to die. Then I need the foot to come down. Yes, thank you. Because really, like, the crux of my damage, as sad as it is still Attack Fly. So anytime, like, the rotation lines up with... Oh, that's how I got hit. I just walked into the enemy. We still got to deal with the angel, though. Scapular. It's fine. Not a glowing endorsement, necessarily, but it's the truth. Scapular, it's pretty good. Hopefully we get another deal with the angel on this floor. I don't like our odds of it. It is possible, though. I'm very happy we bought the map. Where's Pin? I was gonna say, like, we've been fighting for, like, 15 seconds, and Pin was, like, just showing up now. Sorry, guys. Late night. Oh, my God. Are you seeing this malarkey? We gotta charge up our shot, man. Yeah, I don't think I'm tap shooting anymore. I think my analysis of tap shooting was incorrect. Because it seems like if I just hit an enemy with a shot, they die. If I tap shoot, I have to shoot them for like 15 seconds straight. I don't know why 15 is my second counter of the day. Don't question it. This floor is all about the angel room, if we can get it. We should win this run, and we should have very little trouble in doing so. But what I would not give for a high damage angel item, man. You have no idea. Look, flatworm's a very interesting item. Very interesting trinket, I guess I should say. I don't like it nearly as much as I like having a lot of keys. I like that you guys are slow right now, though. Not red chests, which means I'm not motivated to open them. Yeah, wait till it gets fully charged. I think that helps. Plus, it's a little easier on my wrist. Not that I don't have, like, any kind of repetitive wrist injury or something like that, or, you know, RSI or carpal tunnel, but I want to keep it that way if possible. Occasionally, you know, I'm tapping it like crazy. I end up, like, my finger joints or tendons start to ache a little bit. Probably a sign to take a short break, I guess. That's just chocolate milk in a nutshell. Are we going to go into the curse room? I'd rather... Well, let me put it this way. In an ideal world, yes. In our current world, which is far from ideal, no. It's a possibility, though, in the future, if we get very lucky. Get enough spirit hearts. Of course, these guys would be, like, the one enemy that doesn't die in one hit. At least they're going to be easier to hit than normal. Boss room's got to be down here. I mean, we've done a good chunk of due diligence here, I'd say. Careful. Should only be two of these. Big room, then boss room. So it's not going to be a big boss room. Man, we had no chance of getting cube of meat on this one. Three bombs. I mean, I like it. We're going to maybe find a good use for those. Oh, man. Remember when spiders almost made me eat shit on the first floor? This is the penance for that. Man, it's like watching a fight where there's like 100% certainty who's going to win, but it's not a blowout. But it's like literally 100% certain. I guess we're not literally 100% certain we're going to win, but come on, it's looking pretty good. Mostly thanks to Broken Stopwatch, because we haven't gotten shit since then. Shit since then, that would be a great like punk band name. I knew you were going to be some asshole who had the ability to fly. As soon as I brought Lemon Party in, I'm like, oh, big mistake. He's going to be able to fly. Don't touch me. Now, slow conquest is an easy conquest. It's the law of the jungle, baby. We can stand, like, right next to you and you can't do shit about it. That at least feels good. Now, we could use Pandora's... You know what? We gotta... Oh, I punched my mic. That's how surprised I was. Yes. Okay. Yes. 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 We're gonna take Horror of Babylon. The damage is too good. We're gonna use this. And we ended up not getting great payouts from it. What was my thinking behind using this? Give me the ability to fly. Basically. Yes, I did it for White Pony. Is White Pony good? No. I did it anyway. I don't care. It's gonna... It cost us a deal with the angel. Oh well. A deal with the angel item, I should say. It didn't cost us a deal with the angel. Very slight but literal difference. Oh, the speed is real. I don't regret this decision at all. For a second, I was like, am I going to regret this? No, my friend. I'm not going to regret this. This feels great. Okay. I'm back, baby. Horror Babylon damage actually means that tap shooting is viable. And a full shot takes out, like, most of these fistula parts. I knew there was going to be another one. You know, I'm not expecting a Nobel Prize or anything for that. Like, these guys might as well not even be here. This room is just time. How do you feel about this room? You know, time. This room, it doesn't even carry, like, any uncertainty with it that we could be going in the wrong direction. It's basically just like, I'm going to take, you know, a minute and a half of your time. And I know I'm going to say no. It's a telemarketer call where you're too polite to tell them to fuck off right off the bat. I'm not trying to shit on you telemarketers. I worked as a telemarketer for a while through my school. Sucks, man. You know, you're humans. That's a rough job to make humans do because you pretty much, you know, hey, we're going to pay you, like, probably not that much money to get yelled at. You, like, every time you pick up, well, you don't even get to pick up the phone. We'll just auto dial it for you because, you know, otherwise your efficiency might fall. But there's about a 25% chance you're going to get yelled at. About a 70% chance that the person on the other end is just going to be polite but say no. And then, legitimately, I wasn't running a scam or anything like that. It's like donations for our, for like their alma mater, school they went to. Which was actually worse for some people. They're like, don't you have enough of my money? And like, ah, sir, I don't know. I'm like fucking 17, right? Anyway. Like a 5% chance that people were like, hey, yeah, thanks for calling. Here's 20 bucks for the school. That's a rough life, man. It's worse, I imagine, if you run like tech support or something like that. I'm always very polite to service people, and it's always service people sounds like a judgment in and of itself. They're polite to people who work in the service and retail industry. So they're not service people. That's not their role in life, is to serve. Oh, now you just, oh my god, I whiffed. Oh, thank god. It's judge people by the way that they treat service people as well. You know, your phone broke, you call tech support. You're not calling, you know, hi, this is, Mr. Samsung. What's wrong with your phone? Oh, sorry, I must have fucked up making that, right? You're calling, like, somebody who maybe doesn't even, like, live in your country. It's fucked up, man. It's a weird world. Anyway, that's the other thing. People are always like, you know, oh, you're probably, call your credit card company. Oh, you're probably not even, like, Canadian or American who I'm talking to. What do you fucking care? Why don't you go down to the bank, motherfucker, if you want to talk to somebody who's, like, probably, you know, Canadian or American. Sit on your lazy ass, phone in. No, you don't understand. I demand homegrown, cheap, constantly available, 24/7, by correspondence tech support. Anyway, I don't want to get political with it. I'm just saying, be polite to service people, all right? It makes you an asshole if you're not polite to them. It doesn't make you any kind of big shot. Everybody's going to have to occupy that role at one point in their life. I've been a service person. So many people work in the restaurant industry, work retail. Everyone's got a horror story. It's because people are assholes. Don't pay it forward. Just be a nice person. If you can. And I'm guilty of not being a nice person from time to time. Of course, I'm not going to sit here and tell you that I'm not. I'm just to be nice, you know? Anyway, that's the kind of things we talk about when the Isaac runs take 100 years here. As much as I would love this to go to the left, let's be honest. We're going down. I know, by the way, that White Pony has an active effect. It's OSCAR. White Pony also has a passive effect. It's MEYER. Should have done telemarketing for Oscar Mayer Wiener. They're not that good, are they? Just a great jingle. I'd rather have a ballpark any day of the week. Oh, they're like this, yeah. Stop hitting yourself. Seriously, though. Keep hitting yourself, because this is going to take 20 years otherwise. I'm so excited that we're down to the chest soon and with 8 items. I have to admit, you know, this is like Vince Gilligan being like, yo, you know, if you're going to skip one episode of Breaking Bad, you should skip this one. But if you're going to, like, you know, skip through one episode of Isaac, it's probably best if it's this one. You know, just tab ahead, see if I win. You're lucky. I don't have that luxury, you know. I got to sit here through this whole fucking thing, whether I want to or not, and be like, ugh. Jeez. You can just go ahead and say, like, oh, he gets Epic Fetus on the next floor. You know how, like, 2 runs ago, I got Epic Fetus and was like, oh, I don't take Epic Fetus unless blah, blah, blah. I would take Epic Fetus in a heartbeat. Give it to me right now. This is the 1% situation where it's like, oh, we've gotten... I mean, we have Horror of Babylon now, so it's not so bad, but... Jesus Christ. What a slow-paced, kind of boring run we've got right now. Good. Thank God for that Horror of Babylon pickup, though. If we got to deal with the angel instead of a deal with the devil, who knows what kind of fate might have befallen us. You didn't die in one hit? Who do you think you are? I am. Well, how are you guys doing out there in TV land? Yeah, me too. Just flew in. Boy, are my arms tired. Didn't we have, like, oh, we had a High Priestess last time we fought this guy, so it was, like, a little faster. It's not good when you fought Mega Fatty early in the run. It's easier than when you fight Mega Fatty late in the run. Not just because there's 2 of them. but because you're doing, well, you don't have enough damage to compensate for High Priestess. Mind you, High Priestess is really good, but still. Okay. Thank God we have bombs. Our vanilla bombs are like the greatest shit of all time right now. I know I'm taking damage in the it's 100% entirely impatience. Look, I'm not proud of that, but I'm not proud of anything about this run right now. Long way to go until we get to that boss fight. So just play it as smart as you possibly can. Got a tap shoot to take out the easy enemies at least. Don't waste your charge time on them. He's almost dead. Those feet still come down with some serious speed, unfortunately. There we go. Oh my god. Okay, just be cool. That's what we're looking for right there. The world's greatest attack fly. How are we this late in the game and still relying on attack fly for so much damage? Oh, you... You're lucky. That's what you are. I was gonna say you're lucky. Oh. Lovely. All we... Okay. I mean, we're in a good position. Our number one enemy here is ourselves. I should just stay away. Especially with the soul, we're like pushing these bullets away. But man, even with Horror Babylon, Cricket's Head, Chocolate Milk, our damage is so bad. But the Yara Rune. Be filled with hope, Yara who enter here. I'm so excited by the possibilities that this run can be afforded by that very simple Yara Rune. What is wrong with me? Very nearly took damage there. Don't move, buddy. Yeah, we can actually get in there with Attack Fly. Because the soul protects us. It's still plausible to get hit with it, but, you know, if we get hit once or twice, as far as I'm concerned, it's well worth it for that Attack Fly damage that actually does something to hurt this enemy. Good. Who comes after Blue Baby? It's Eve, right? Well, get used to Horror Babylon. Hopefully we have the privilege of using it a lot on that Eve run that comes next. We did it. We didn't get hit at all either, which is kind of nice. This is the moment of truth. Just no HP. I don't care. Just give me damage items. We've got so many keys. Let me do... Oh, it's good. It's good. It's good with Holy Mantle. It's okay. It's good. It's okay. It's not okay. It's okay for more chests in the future. Okay, so there's good stuff happening here. The Holy Mantle pickup might be big. I can totally take Bob's brain with this. Show me the way to go so we can speed this run up a little bit. Oh, never mind. We'll just take the Emperor card. And I guess if we don't really want the ability to fly, we'll just take Lemon Mishap with us. Game, you're too kind. Thank you. We did manage to catch him there. It's good. We'll generate some flies. You know, I don't know how effective the flies are going to be. But we're already doing all right. I love you, Bob's Brain. Bob's Brain, be the change you want to see in the world here, buddy. I love it. Oh, for Christ's sake, sneak some bombs in there. I don't care. Might just touch the shit out of him. There's our permanent Polaroid invincibility. Yeah, fuck his life up. Oh, man. It's over. That was like pulling teeth. I apologize, but hey. You gotta get your teeth pulled. We got another win. We're up to 5. We'll be back next time with a Eve run. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, click the like button. It helps out a great deal. And of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.